Yeah, so this is me and I'm here today. It's the 6th of Jan and I have an appointment with the PSI and we'll see how things go on right now. Okay, and don't mind my voice, I'm not carrying the speakers, I'm not carrying the mic today. Okay, hello there. So I'm here in North Goa, I'm speaking from North Goa, and today I want to narrate to you something about, you know, this journey of the Divine Feminine, the empowerment journey of the Divine Feminine. A lot of people talk about integrating polarities, okay, which is empowerment for the Divine Feminine, balancing your polarities. But this is intricate work, this is inner work, and this is intricate work, you know, it requires deep thought. You know, it's not something that is accomplished on the shallow level. That's why we say meditation. Why meditation? Because it is in meditation that you actually have those deep thoughts and those deeper insights, because your mind needs to be at a higher level of frequency, which happens in meditation. Okay, so I have a situation currently in my life where there is a neighbor who is was continuously targeting me, harassing me, you know, psychic attacks, because this year is somewhere a very important year for me in terms of clearing ancestral karma. So the dark forces, the negatives, are doing their best to, you know, create imbalance in the masculine, you know, prevent me from holding the masculine balance. Okay, so all these kinds of attacks happen, all these kinds of, you know, the matrix uses any mind that is imbalanced, any mind that is injured. Can use anyone, can use anybody, just anybody. Okay, so I filed a complaint on him, and I was interacting with the police, and it was in process. Okay, my case was in process, but what happened is, when I was interacting with the police, I was waiting for them to get back to me, because that's what my lawyer had told me. He had told me, you know, the police will call you. But I think maybe there was a misunderstanding on the part of the lawyer, because from the police perspective, he was done with the case, you know, that was it. But the lawyer had told me, you wait for the police call. So I was waiting, because I was thinking that in my case, in my matter, there was an incident where the neighbor had verbally abused me. Okay, so a lot of Divine Feminines would be keeping quiet, right? You know, so these things happen normally in the society. This thing happens normally in the neighborhood. But no, the thing is, we are here to change the templates, okay? Because if such issues are ignored, then it grows to the big level, okay? First, women are verbally abused. They keep quiet and the energy drain happens. See, in our community, we talk about the energy drain, the shadow masculine draining the energy, okay? So the energy drain happens, and if you keep giving away power like that, you know, you let somebody abuse you, then what happens is, then the crimes increase to the next level, okay? Then something else will happen, you know, somebody will physically assault you, or some rapes happen, or things like that happen. Why these things happen? Because we have the really deep ingrained pattern of giving our power away, of allowing this energy drain, okay? And the whole society is based against that. We have laws, like here in Goa, we have laws against verbal abuse. But, you know, at the society level, at the level of the people, it is ignored. It is not taken into consideration. So on one hand, it's about changing the laws. But on the second hand, it's also about bringing the awareness. And I'm imagining that if it isn't like this here in Goa, which is supposed to be a really, you know, Goa is supposed to be quite high on the literacy level and awareness level. But if it is like this in Goa, what will be in the rest of the parts of India, I don't know. It will be far worse. It will be far worse. And women will have to walk on the streets with their heads down, I suppose. Okay, and if somebody say anything to them, just keep quiet about it. No, because this neighbor of mine, he falsely accused me of some negative things, defamed my identity only because I had complained against his father for the music disturbance. And they are both bullies and they kind of dominate the whole village. They disturb. So I had a complaint with the police station. And recently what happened is I was calling the sub-inspector with whom I was dealing with, but he wasn't picking my call, he wasn't picking my text. Okay, fine, I understand people are busy, but you can call me back, right? You can call me back. If you can't manage time to call me back, at least call me back at the end of the day. Or, you know, call me back next day regarding the matter, or at least text me. You know, but one can always pick up the call and just say, I will get back to you on this. Okay. But what I'm pointing out in this scenario is that there is no, way of behaving, okay, with the public. You know, the police are behaving based on how the person is who is in front of them. Okay, if they see that you are quiet type, because my attitude is like that. I think first when I went, I came off as a very quiet person, okay. And the thing is sometimes I tend to lose my nerve also. I tend to get angry very fast. For that reason I had sent my lawyer. Okay, I had not gone personally, because sometimes I tend to lose my calm and I don't want to interact with the police in that situation when I lose my calm. So maybe I'm having an issue with having control over my emotions. So I am working on myself in all these ways. But the thing is, point is, the police don't always behave in the right ways with you. Like for example, I had a misunderstanding regarding this matter. I thought this matter is yet to be resolved. The accused is yet to be called in the police station, because that is what my lawyer had told me, that the police will give you a call. So I was waiting for his call, and I waited for around 15 days and I didn't get the call back. So I was thinking, like, why they have not got back to me. So I called them and I was not getting any reply. I was not getting any text back. So then I called a PI, and as soon as I called a PI, I get a text back. I get a reply, and I also get an appointment. And today I had my appointment. I went and I met the sub-inspector, and he clarified and he told me that the further meetings will happen, further resolution of the matter will happen, not in the police station, but in the collector's office. Okay, I wasn't clear about this. Okay, but because my advocate had told me the cop will call you. So maybe there was a bit of a misunderstanding, but even if there was a bit of a misunderstanding, the call has to be picked, right? Because if I have clarified something about the case, I have to be attended to it. Okay, and if the inspector is busy, sub-inspector is busy, then they should give me a time and a date. And I have hardly taken 15 minutes, okay, not more than 15 minutes, okay. So the matter was resolved. But I noticed one thing, that when I mentioned about the fact that, you know, I'm answerable to my community regarding these matters, because I have to set an example for others. When I typed that, that was when I get a reply back. Before that, I didn't get a reply back. Then when I called the PI, that is when I get a reply back. Before that, I didn't get a reply back. Before that, my calls were being ignored. Why? Because if you see that it's just a woman, you think she doesn't deserve clarification regarding the matter. You think the matter has to be neglected. Why are you projecting your own stories onto the matter, that maybe it's a insignificant matter and I'm making a big deal out of it? No, it's not an insignificant matter. Because if I don't take action against this verbal abuse issue, then there will be more of it. And there will be more against other women also. Okay? Because this person, whoever has verbally abused me, the neighbor, he has had issues with other women as well. You know, that is how it is. He has had issues with other women as well. And he was in prison for rape. and assault, physical assault. So right now the matter is at the collector's level, okay, and my advocate will go and check what happens regarding this matter. Yeah, but I had issues with the police station because of this reason, because many times I have even experienced that they don't pick up the calls, you know, and the excuse is I am busy, okay. So what had happened is I contacted one NGO here nearby where I live, and I explained to the NGO that the police are neglecting the case, okay. So when I did that, I wrote a complaint and all, and I was ready with the next steps, okay, what to do. So my thing to you is, what I want to convey to you is, you cannot keep quiet, you know. If somebody is, you cannot ignore such matters, because if somebody like physically, like verbally abuses you, or you know, harasses you, then what happens is your divine masculine is getting imbalanced, and it is causing separation between you and your twin flame if you keep quiet, okay. If you don't be in your power, if you give your power away, okay, this is one way in which the separation happens, because you're suppressing your solar plexus, right? You're suppressing your solar plexus, you're suppressing your power, right? You're suppressing your power. So I don't think I will go and complain right now, because yes, his attitude was neglectful, but right now he has attended to my case, and he was also very apologetic in his behavior. So I think he had a different image of me in my mind, that you know, like I'm just a woman and I will not speak up and all those things. You know how men tend to look at women as weak, you know, not responsive, not assertive. But I just look like that sometimes. I'm not like that. My personality is not like that, because you, as you know, the divine feminine, she has a very soft nature, you know, she has a very respectful nature, okay. I always have this feeling of friendship and respect towards the divine masculine, okay. But sometimes my attitude is misunderstood as being needy for attention, and my attitude is misunderstood as being weak. It is not weakness, it is just my respect that I have for the divine masculine. It's just my friendly attitude that I have towards the divine masculine. It doesn't mean that I am needy for attention. No, I'm not needy for attention. In fact, there are lots of people who are looking for my attention, but I don't give them, simply because I have standards, I have obligations. And my attention is very important. I have to choose which people I give my attention to. Because for me, I seriously work from the perspective of creating 5D timelines. And I'm very careful about whom I empower with my energy, whom I add value to with my energy. Okay. So my friends and those people who I want in my circle, they have to be of a certain mindset, you know. They have to be of a certain mindset. They cannot be anti-environment. They cannot be anti-animals. They cannot be anti-women. You know, are you getting me what I'm saying? So there is a certain standard for me, okay? And I have done a lot of work on myself. I'm not a teenager who's looking for attention. Okay, I'm not a teenager who's looking for attention, but I have a respectful attitude. But sometimes what happens is, the divine masculine tend to think, the masculine tend to think, or let's just say the men tend to think, that your respectful attitude is your weakness, okay, or your friendly attitude is your weakness, okay. So this is how it is. Basically, you don't have an option. When you are a twin flame, you don't have an option. You have to give your best when it comes to your power, both financially, in social situations, you know, things like that. So you just simply don't have a choice to give your power away. okay? And for me, when you are an illumined twin flame, you're directly connected into the collective consciousness. So you're carrying certain ancestral and collective patterns, but when you break those patterns, you shift the collective in a very powerful way. So I don't have an option of functioning through the old patterns. I have to speak up. Okay, if the police system is not working well, I will speak up against that. If some other system is not working well, I will speak up against them. Okay, and I will build my connections, okay, to other activists who are there, because I am here to contribute. Okay, and nobody rejects a person who wants to contribute. Okay, now it's a different matter that you have to find those people who jive with you, who are with you on your frequency to work, whether even when you're doing your activism stuff. Okay, you have to find people who jive with you, right? So yeah, basically it's like that, you know. Like say for example, like I live in Goa over here, and you can see the sea ahead. You know, this is the sea. This is the river actually, and the river goes and merges with the sea. Okay. So actually for me, being the divine feminine and you know, being into spirituality, this is not the balanced environment for me, because the balanced environment for me would be the hilly regions, the mountain regions, okay, because the prithvi tattva is high over there. But because I was carrying polarity karma, I was born here in a coastal state, that is Goa, okay, because I was carrying polarity karma. Yeah, so we are talking about imbalance. So I was born in this region of this coastal area because I was carrying heavy polarity karma of the polarized feminine, of the shadow feminine. So, you know, the sea represents femininity, okay, and I was also carrying those energies. So it was because of that polarity that I was born in the coastal region, and I was also told by an astrologer that I will always be living near a river or near a sea or near a chapel or a church. And that is true, because I'm living near the sea and my house is like 10 minutes from the sea on the bike or in the car, and there are two chapels in front of my house, because that is because a certain planet, a very important planet, is in Pisces. Okay, so Pisces represents the sea. Pisces also represents spirituality and spiritual organizations, structures. So for that reason, I was born there. But I have a feeling right now that the more I'm coming into balance, I need to move to hilly regions. You know, that is what I feel. So I'm having that calling to go closer to nature, because although the sea is beautiful and I love the sea so much, still the sea, what it represents is, it represents transmutation. Okay, because if you think deeply, all the dirt of the entire land, it goes into the sea, okay, and the sea transmutes it. Because of the salt content in the sea and the other chemicals, the sea transmutes all this dirt into salt, okay, and it really cleanses. So what the sea basically does, it takes all the poison and transmutes. So it's a transmutation process, okay. So likewise, the twin flames have taken on karma to transmute, and once that ancestral karma is transmuted, okay, I think that is when I will have to move from here to a purer place, because I think the sea is beautiful, I think the sea is pure, but I need to move to a place that is more pure, like the mountains, because the mountains is where the sea originate, the rivers originate, and the atmosphere is pure there for the most part. If some ugly cities are not built around that area, and if some sick humans are not living over there, okay. So apart from those things, you know, the mountains are very pure places to be. So that's where I want to go. That's where I'm called to be. Because if you look at this place in Goa where I live here, it's completely ruined, because all these outsiders are coming here in Goa, and They are playing loud music. They are completely destroying the integrity and the peace of the nature over here. There is hardly any riverside, seaside left that is peaceful. Okay, there is a constant energy drain that is happening with all this music that is playing, and uncontrolled tourism, and you know, there is no quality control on the tourism. The government is not employing the right laws. You know, there is a lot of corruption happening here because the beaches are being like sold. It's like you know, these people who are in power, it's like they're selling their motherland. I'm sorry to say it, but they're selling their motherland. And if this continues, very soon there will not be any good quality tourist in Goa. There will just be all these mediocre quality tourists in Goa, and due to which the crimes will increase, I think, and the quality people will not want to live here. I don't think the quality people will want to live here. Because humans have to live in balance with nature. They cannot be a drain on nature. Okay? And if you look at the rivers and the seas here, we see that the local people who are living over here, the locals, they are losing their peace. You know, they are completely losing their peace. Okay, like say for example, right now I'm here at this riverside, and somebody has come here and they're playing loud music here, disturbing the locality. So that is what I mean. You know, this is what I mean. So this is what I have to say with you today.